When we're trying to find the graph of a linear equation, here's one thing we can use to our advantage. So we understand that any point on the graph of an equation is going to be an ordered pair x, y that has the special property that this x and this y, when you plug it in, are going to make the equation be true. Now, points that are not on the line, like here and here, these xy ordered pairs would not make the equation be true. So when you look at a line like negative x, y equals negative x plus 4, you'll have points on it like 0, 4, because if you plug in 0 for x and 4 for y, 0 plus 4 really does equal 4. And 1, 3, and 2, 2, and 3, 1, and 4, 0. And the special property that all these points have is if you plug in the x and the y simultaneously into the equation, they are going to make the equation be true. And so we can use that to our advantage to find the graph of linear equations like this. And so here's some steps that we can do to find the graph of a linear equation if we want to do it using points. So step number one is to, first of all, solve the equation for y if it's not already solved for y. A lot of these equations, like this one, will already have y equals. And if it doesn't have y equals, then we should make it be y equals using algebra, adding and subtracting, multiplying and dividing. All right, next we're going to draw an xy table. What we're going to attempt to do is find a list of ordered pairs that make the equation be true, like this list of xy values. And so right now we're not going to find the points quite yet. We're just going to draw the empty table. So just draw a vertical line with two columns, an x column and a y column. All right, now to actually fill out that column, here's how we're going to do that. You and I are going to choose some x values. These are completely of our own choice. There's no right or wrong x values you have to pick. Just choose any x values. And then what you'll find is that there are some y values that would complement those x values that will make the equation be true. Let's look back at our previous example. For instance, let's look at maybe this point right here. So if we just simply chose to let the x be 3, if we let the x value be 3, and we did not choose a y value to go with it, look at what would happen. We would have negative 3 plus 4, and then this will tell us, hey, we really need to let our y value equal 1 if we want this to be a solution. So what happens is we will choose the x's, and then we'll let the algebra figure out what the y values need to be that will complement those x values. And what we'll get after we plug in those x values to find the corresponding y is we'll get a whole table full of xy ordered pairs, a whole table of points. And so the last two steps are to plot the points, take those ordered pairs and put them on a graph. Now, what should happen when we plot these ordered pairs? Well, again, looking back at this picture we have here, if done correctly, they should line up in a straight line. And so that should very clearly reveal what the graph of the linear equation should be. It's simply the line that goes through those points that you found. So the last step we have, number 6, is to simply connect the dots, and you've got your graph of your linear equation. All right, now this method here, this is only one method, one way of graphing a linear equation. There are a couple of other ways we can graph linear equations that we'll look at in the next videos. This particular way has a few benefits, a few pros, and a few cons. So let me highlight just the big ones. The pros of graphing lines this way is that it's very straightforward and easy. You pick some x's, you find the y's that go with them, and you plot them, and it shows you your line. It's very, very low amount of errors that are typically run into with this type of technique, because it's even self-correcting, believe it or not. Let me go back to this picture here. Let's say you were making up an xy table, and you found the first point okay, and you found the second point okay. Let's say this one was fine, and this one was fine, and this one was fine. But let's say we made an algebra mistake and messed up on the third point, and maybe put our dot out here for some reason. We accidentally did a minus instead of a plus or something like that. Well, you see very quickly that these don't line up anymore. So you say, oh, wait, I must have done something wrong with this ordered pair. You go check your algebra. You see your mistake. It's fixed. Then you put it back where it should be, and then you're off on your way. So it's very, very difficult to make too many errors doing this method unless you make some consistent algebra mistake over and over again repeatedly. But usually you'll spot your mistake if you only make one mistake or two mistakes or something. The downside, there is a negative to this method, is that this is very time consuming. You know, doing six steps to graph a linear equation is kind of a lot, because you have to solve for y, make your table, pick the x's, plug them all in, find the y's, plot the points, connect the dots. It's just very time consuming, and it turns out some of the other techniques that we're going to learn coming up are a lot faster. And so, you know, if we were to come back and graph some linear equations towards the end of the course, this would probably not be the ideal way of graphing lines, but as we're just learning how to graph linear equations, this is a great way to begin to learn how to graph linear equations. So let's wrap up this video with an example. Let's say we were trying to graph the linear equation y plus 2x equals negative 1. So let's run through these steps real quick. Step 1 is to solve for y. So we'll take this guy and write it as y equals, we'll have to subtract the 2x to the right, y equals negative 2x minus 1. So this will be the equation we're going to use for the xy table. All right, next up, we're going to make that xy table. So we'll do a vertical line to separate out two columns, like so. And then we'll have an x column and a y column. And then we just need to pick any amount of x's, and it doesn't even matter what the x's are. Just to be consistent, most people will go from minus 2 to 2. That's absolutely not necessary, but it's nice to pick points around 0 so that your graph is centered around the origin. Technically, we could have picked x's like 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15, but then our graph would have been way over here. And normally when you draw your xy axis, you're going to see the origin right there in the center. So now these are the x's, but I don't know the y's that go with those x's. So the next step will be to take these x values and plug them in for x into the equation. And now it's actually clear why we solve for y before we begin. This way, if you have y solved for, when you plug in for x, you immediately get your answer. You immediately get your y. If you plugged in x into the first equation, every single step you would have to solve for y repeatedly, but this makes it a lot easier. So let's run through the algebra. Negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. 4 minus 1 makes y equals 3. So we'd have negative 2 comma 3. That'd be one ordered pair on our graph. So let's go ahead and start making our graph as we find these points. Okay, so we'll plot negative 2 comma 1, 2, 3. So that point will be plotted right here. All right, next up, plug in negative 1. Negative 2 times negative 1 is positive 2. 2 minus 1 makes 1. So we'll plot negative 1, 1. That's right here. Next up, plug in 0. 0 minus 1 is negative 1. So we'll plot 0 comma negative 1, which is right here. Then plug in 1. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. Negative 2 minus 1 makes negative 3. So we'll plot 1 comma negative 3. And last point, plug in an x value of 2. Negative 2 times 2 makes negative 4. Minus 1 makes negative 5. So 2 comma negative 5 is down here. And sure enough, if you do it correctly, do you see how they all lined up in a row? If we had made a mistake on one of these points, let's say we messed up on our algebra and we plotted a point over here, then notice these would not line up in a straight line anymore. So we would go fix our algebra, but everything looks fine here. So the last step to draw the graph of this linear equation, all we simply do is just connect these dots that are already in a line. So that blue line represents this linear equation. And now we don't even need these highlighted dots. Now, just a last point I want to make here about this graph here. You notice there are other points on this graph other than the ones we've highlighted, like here and here and here and, you know, all these places here. Those are additional XY points that are not in our table, but they still would have made the equation be true. So these XY order pairs are a great way to begin to learn how to graph linear equations.